Hello, hello. No watermelon game today because I started so late. Although I do want to play watermelon game, but yeah, we're just doing Factorio because I probably only have like maybe an hour and a half or so. Yeah, I was busy doing some housework today, so I wasn't able to stream as early as I'd like. Why is this so quiet? Oh, because I was in radar view. Yeah, once again, that will always cause issues. Okay, so how is my astro science production? Not great. It's running low on visible observation data. Okay, so yeah, as expected, we are out of cooling fluid. Let's see, are these producing as fast as they can? See, is that correct? Yeah, I have some penguin socks on today. I really like this pair. Plus, they look semi-formal. Not like I really need my socks to be formal, but you know, they make me feel fancier. Okay, I feel like I could probably increase the amount of, what are those called? Radiators? Yeah, thermal radiators I have, but I also need another hypercooler. Which there is a chance I do have a hypercooler. Let's see. Can I like just request one? I think I don't have one, but figured I would should check. Oh, I don't have solid rocket fuel. Yeah, I figured it would be a good idea to test it before I got too committed to this idea of actually designing around it. I don't have any rocket fuel. How do I not have rocket? Oh, because it's disabled. That would do it. Yeah, that tricks me a lot. I like to enable and disable this frequently, and I never actually like fix it. Okay, so this is making scaffolding. Okay, that's fine. It's making a lot of scaffolding. Wait, what's my limit? 5,000. I can't even fit 5,000 in a chest. Okay. I mean, that's not a big deal. Because occasionally we'll deconstruct stuff and it'll go back into a storage vessel. Okay, so we needed a hypercooler and a super cooler or something like that. I don't think either of those words are right. Okay, there's one of those. Okay. Well, now we have two of them. And okay, we have enough pumps so I can get more radiators. Cool. I feel like I should start shipping pumps up here. I didn't realize pumps would be used for so much in space, but it makes sense. I mean, you need to move fluids around and that's kind of the only way to do it, especially since you don't even have gravity. Well, I mean, we're stuck to the Earth, but I mean, you know, you have less things to naturally move the water around, which I don't know if that's a positive or negative, but these are also real slow. That's fine. Because we produced all we could. Okay, we'll take the pump just in case we need to use it. Okay, so I have five more radiators, two hypercoolers. That should be more than enough. I don't think I have any more speed. I feel like I ran out of speed modules. Or maybe I just didn't have any more on me. I'm not necessarily out. Yeah, I think I might have some. Okay, that's the last hypercooler I have. Okay, and bots do have more speed modules. Cool. Wait, how many do I have up here? Logistics network, speed, 125. Oh, cool. So I don't need to like try to ration them or anything like I did here. That's good to know. Let's just request some. Because we're gonna need a few speed modules. Where you at? Where you at? Never remember. Okay, 50. Yeah, that should be good enough. Okay, so hopefully we can somehow get this to cool. Although it's looking like it's gonna be a bit more awkward than I would like. Let's see, can I move this particle accelerator a little bit? I think I could. That would let me fit it here. Which I don't know if it's necessarily a great spot, but it does fit there. So yeah, we're just gonna move the particle accelerator just a little bit to the right. Replace this with underground, although I don't think I needed to do that. Okay, cannot build on space platform. Oh, that's because it's the wrong type. Okay, so this should work now. It still has the efficiency modules. Good. Now we can somehow connect these. Yeah, that's harder than I would have liked. Okay, well this part's easy. This part also easy. The output is trickier than I would like, though. Because, like, I could set it up to output to the left, but it doesn't have the logic on it that I would need it to have. So we could either use a separate pump, or we can try to wrap it around and connect here. Wait, does this need logic? This one might not lead. Wait, this one might not lead logic. Or I could give it new logic. That might be easier. Let's see. Let's see how that works out. Can I fit a pump in here? Yes? Okay, yeah, that works. Let's just do a red wire then. I still, honestly, I don't think this pump is strictly necessary, like, because I don't think there's a feedback loop, but just in case, it is nice to have it. Or I don't think there's, it's not a positive feedback loop, but I think these are always consumed. Because at the moment, I don't have anything that will accidentally just produce thermofluid. So if these back up, I don't think that messes with our recycling at all. Because we basically just want to convert it all. But just in case, like, maybe there's something later down the line that use, like, ultra, super, hyper cooling. I don't know. Probably wouldn't have that many adjectives. So that still connects there. And then I need a hot output, which is trickier than I thought. Oh gosh, I hate this. But I'm not changing it. It works. Okay, we're good. Then we add some speed modules to it. Also, what is this boosting? Okay, this would actually be better suited if I moved it here somehow. That definitely won't fit. Okay, so instead we're just gonna move these speed mods. Because I feel like dedicated speed mods are definitely better than ones in assembly machines. Wait, why didn't that work? Or than ones in beacons? If they're only affecting a single machine, so I figured I might as well use my higher priority ones. Okay, so does this work? Do I have enough radiators? I feel like I don't. Oh wait, am I running into the pressure issue that someone was talking about already? Hopefully not. I mean, yeah, someone did warn me that this might happen. I just figured it would be a little bit ways away, because this doesn't feel like I have that large of a base. Do I need more pumps? Will more pumps fix things? I don't really know. I don't really know what the problem is. I probably didn't break things, at least, so I'm just going to leave them. It could just be that we're not consuming enough, too. I mean, these are getting enough fluid now. That's all that matters. This number is, I can't tell. I think it's increasing, because it was at 200 before. It's very slow, but I think we do have a slight positive. Do we have enough power production? Yes. Yes, we do. Okay. Good. We actually have, we have improved our astroscience, so hopefully we should be getting like 2 a second now, or something like that. I mean, I would want more, but honestly, we can make do with this. And then I think, let's see, rocket reusability, perfect. Wow, there's a lot of tiers of this that use just space. Oh my gosh. Wait, does this only use space science until like the end of time? There's no way I'm gonna get 8,000 astro science by queuing these all up. Well, that's fine. Yeah, I can't really tell, but I'm assuming. Oh wait, yeah, no, this is the last one. I figured at some point it would transition to a different science. Wait, what's this? Whoa, what is this thing? Faster but more resource inefficient cooling of overheated fluid. What does that mean? What is resource efficiency in terms of cooling a fluid? Is it lossy? Oh, it loses 10% instead of 2%. How much faster is it? Like, that doesn't sound worth it. Oh wait, what's this one? This one loses less. But how much slower is it? 200 seconds. Whereas this one is 10 seconds. So it's, that one's twice the speed, but 10% less lossy. And the other one is 10% more lossy. Which is significant. But five, is that also, no, that one's four times. 4 times faster? Okay, yeah, that is pretty significant. I mean, considering I have a design like this, I can see how that would matter at some point. These do seem to be working plenty fast enough, though. This is a slight positive. Cool. I have Astro Science of unspecified amount. We'll leave it running for a bit. I can't imagine it's more than like 1 per hour. Like it's, well, maybe it's not that bad, but it's definitely not a lot. Wait, can this back up anything other than utility science? I don't think so. Yeah, I think we're good. Why is copper so low? Copper was running out for a bit there. But it seems to be good now. I wonder if we had just connected a belt somewhere. Oh wait, what here uses copper? Oh, I know. It's because we made a bunch of thermal radiators. We just immediately used like 2,000 copper. So we just burned through what was on the belt. That's fine. These are not running perfectly efficiently, but that's okay. It looks like we can get a little bit more Astro Science, but yeah, we're gonna run out of Astro Science soon. That's fine. How's my water ice? Yeah, it's gonna last a while. We have this rocket. Okay, what was our goal? Well, I want to leave everything I can on this moon base because the last time we, or not really moon base, but I feel like that's a good name for it. Orbit base. But the last time we were up here, we kind of left. We didn't leave anything on us, and we kept like moving space stuff between Novus and the space planet, and it was very, very annoying. I guess I can wait. Speed modules don't go there; they go here. But yeah, it just means I constantly had to filter out things that I shouldn't have had to. Stone, glass, iron, not copper. Okay, wait. We don't use copper here. We'll just put it in that chest. What else do we have? Blank observation frames. Those won't really be used. Light oil can filter out. Is there anything else we use up here? I mean, most of this stuff should stay. Same with the pipes. Same with these. Power poles, probably good to leave. We can always recover them when we go back down. Roboport's always good to leave up here. A requester chest would be nice. We've never really used one up here before, but it would be nice to have one just in case. Biochem, supercomputer, fuel refinery. Okay, all of those are worth leaving. Productivity twos, I don't use those much because they can't go in that many space machines, but I might as well leave a few of them up here. Radars, I don't really need radars, but yeah, my inventory is pretty clear. Wait, thermo facility and space manufacturing machines. Wait, can I place these on land? No. For some reason, I thought I could. I guess that. Yeah, that would be kind of broken, wouldn't it? You could make such efficient machines on Novus like that. Wait, I didn't disable that. I was wondering why those appeared in my inventory again. Okay, and then we'll leave some combinators. I don't know why I have transmitters here. I wonder if I brought too many. It's weird that I have those requested. I don't know if I wanted to take them from here or bring them to here. But it does have transmitters now, so that's, I guess, the important thing. And then let's take a capsule back home with us. We have a large amount of capsules. That is way too much solid rocket fuel. There we go. Okay, head back to Novus, and then we need to figure out what I was doing last time. I think I was trying to set up better cargo processing thingamajiggers. Also, can I just like decon these? Yes. Cool, because they've just kind of been sitting there forever, and we can probably just send them back into the system. We've just been accumulating space capsules around there. As you can see, there are like 10 rockets that we hadn't dealt with. Okay, we have core mining, that's going fine. Our smelting is going good. We're still working on getting speed modules, but these seem to be they're still not great, but they're definitely better. Wow, these are so slow. I wonder if a beacon. Wait, what's the range of a beacon? I can't think of it right now. Is it? Would a beacon build here be better? Let's see. I would be powering Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. At the cost of 2. Unless, if I got prod 3s in it, I think that's better. That is 50% better. It is slightly unbalanced, so I'd also have to have another one down here to make up for it. But yeah, we could definitely put a beacon here. Beacon. Oh, wait. Oh, wait, that doesn't work. Does it? I think, well, okay, I think we can make it work, right? We can just put it one tile over. Yeah, that's okay, that's not a problem. It would be real nice to have that new the new underground force paste feature right here. That would make this so much easier. But I think that's still like at a week away, or not a week away. Months away, like half a year away or something. Super exciting feature, but it's definitely not anytime soon. That still doesn't work there. Don't know why I thought it would be different this time around. Okay, and the reason we had to leave the gap is because we need an underground here. Yeah, because that's how we're passing the fluid through. A year away? Yeah. That's what I meant to say. It's much farther than a week. It's still super exciting. Speed module 3. I really need a better mod than this one. This one is so tedious. What are the other options, actually? This one is called. What is it called? Module inserter simplified. I don't think I like it. I mean, it's better than not having it, but I feel like the non-simplified version probably would have been better. I didn't really look at it. Someone just recommended this one specifically and said they liked it more. It might just be because of my hotkeys that it's annoying though. Because I said it that I can still zoom out while holding shift. I don't know if that was in vanilla or not, but someone. Yeah, you. Do you know if the what makes the simplified version better? Or more preferable to you? See, we're getting plenty of iron. Coal, copper is still low. You never have a zoom problem like you. Well, that's because I specifically changed my keys. Because I like being able to zoom out while holding shift. So I don't have anything bound to holding shift and scroll wheel generally. But yeah, that one I'm aware that one's just my hotkey preferences causing it. It needs no setup, but what kind of setup does the other one need? Is it just like you make a blueprint planner? I guess I could try it. Let's see. What is the other option? Da-da. Module inserter. What is a non-conflict version? Mass insert. Is it this one? Or is it this one? They're all made by different people. Which is the original? I cannot tell which one's the original. Or if there is original. Go by downloads. This one hasn't been modified in a year. Hopefully it works. Confirm. I don't know if having two of them will be bad. It might not work. Now we wait for it to load. I guess it doesn't load that slowly. You just it doesn't detect it until it's like 80% loaded or so for some reason. Okay, let's see if this causes a problem since I have the other one installed. Wait. Did I enable it? I don't know if it's enabled. Oh. Okay, I see what you mean. But having both, I think, would work well, right? Wait, how do I use this one? Copy? Okay, I see now. This will be really nice for builds, though. Definitely nice to have the insert one for just random things, like when I only need a single module type. But that'll be really useful when I'm blueprinting. Like a mining drill lane. Like, what's wrong with nothing wrong with having two of the same mod, basically. It'll be great. Why are these not building? Do we still not have red chips, or did we break it? I don't get why we are out of red chips. Or they're just all becoming. It's not that we're completely out of red chips, it's just that half of our. Oh, wait. Half of our modules are going into speed threes, which is fine. They'll back up soon enough, but I want to get speed twos now, so we'll just. Did I copy? I don't know if I copied this one. Let's see. Yeah, I did. Okay, cool. Rocket usability probably stalled because I imagine we immediately ran out of space science. Oh, we do need this one for space science too. Wait, what is this? Wait, what is this? Add-on power pole? A small electric pole designed to be attached to buildings for precise control over electric coverage? I don't know how that works. That sounds fancy. It also is uses stuff I don't have, so we can't play around with it. But it sounds cool. Ooh, wait, what is this? A huge telescope that detects microwaves in the cosmic microwave background? Ooh. Oh, are these like better specialized telescopes? Or no, never mind, they're not specialized. Ooh, what's this? It's a power pole that is off-grid and can be placed on top of a building. So it just like floats above them. Does it work on every building? Or just the SpaceX ones? Because that sounds neat. For making. Oh, I guess it's marginally ones. Add-on poles are for stringing circuit wires mostly, because pylons have huge. Oh, right. Forgot about pylons. Yeah, you can just use a pylon and have like one power pole every 64 tiles. So the cost savings of placing it on top probably isn't massive. But power circuits, that makes sense. Hold on. I need to grab something real quick. Okay. It was pretty close, so just slightly out of reach. Okay, so what is we have oh, that is a lot more circuits. So I definitely fixed my circuit issue with a completely random ratio here, but it seemed to work out just fine. These are output limited, really? That makes sense. No, that makes sense. This is an easy fix though. We can just go under and replace these instead with fast inserters or even stack inserters, but fast inserters should work. There we go. Okay, so we should be less circuit, even less circuit limited. Although I think things, no, things aren't backing up. Yeah, we could actually use more circuits. Okay, well, is that our bottleneck for red chips right now? No, it is actually just assembly. No, it is slightly. Okay, it is slightly red chip limited. Wow. I mean, I shouldn't be surprised. Green chips are incredibly, like, high demand for practically everything. It's just, it was, we were functioning on off of half of this for so long that we got a pretty sharp spike. If you are lacking resources, I'm not lacking copper. I'm mostly lacking production. And like distribution rather than like the actual resources themselves, at least for now. Don't know how long that will be true. But yeah, we could look into using prods more. I need a redesign. I need to make a new circuit build that just uses beacons and stuff, so then I can just use really good prods in them. But first things first, I want to just make these cheaper, which I think should be pretty easy. Because we have beryllium. which we need to unpack first, but that's really easy. And then half of it will go here. That's the wrong kind of belt. I really need to make a planet-wide hotbar. There's 9 hop, no, 10? There's 10 hotbars to work with, and I'm sitting here just like not using any hotkeys because I keep forgetting to configure that. Okay, half of this needs to go back to novice. I don't remember what uses beryllium. Looks like you need to simplify your base to better distribute your resources. That's not fun. The spaghetti base is the fun part, though. It's clearly not optimal, but that is not something that I care about at all. Because I'm having fun. Can we get some undergrounds here? Yeah. Okay. Does this work? Where does this need to go? It needs to go down here. Okay, so I don't really know if I should unpack it first. I know unpacking the beryllium is better for like rocket throughput, but I feel like the amount of beryllium I need in space at the moment isn't that high. I guess there's no reason to unpack it. Let's see. Where did we have that set up? There should be a launch pad. There it is. Okay, so new plan. I'm actually going to shift this over. And then this one can just output directly here. There we go. That's nice. Do-do-do. We need beryllium plates. Perfect. Honestly, that will be plenty. Beryllium cargo sections seem very useful. I don't know how much beryllium I'm actually producing, though. So I think what I'll do is I'll side load the beryllium here and I'll have the first. Oh, wait, that's not gonna be cryoed right. I'm gonna have to do like some weird folding. I was going to make it that just the second half of this is made without beryllium and the first half is made with it. But that has it has the correct priority for the inputs, but it has the wrong priority for the outputs. So I would need to put them on a separate belt. Which isn't necessarily a problem. It just means I need to do this, basically. But for now, just cut everything. We'll send some RCUs and some LDS into a chest, and then we'll never use it, and we'll forget about it. And yeah, it will be pretty much consumed forever. It'll be perfect. How many can I put on a single beacon? Is it 4 or 5? Four. Okay, so I have a couple options. And the other option doesn't quite work. I don't like where these go. I want to put one here because I like how high these are. We're actually going to move this power pole section and we're going to move the core mining to go underneath this. There we go. And then these should probably be prod threes, because I feel like these are expensive. Especially since we're gonna beacon them. Okay, but yeah, basically I have two options here. Neither of them are fantastic. Maybe if I move the cargo landing pad a little bit to the left. Oh wait, no, I think that's the way to do it. Because I was thinking of having one over here as well. But I think instead it should be on the other side. Over here, which just means we need to move the cargo pod, but that's fine because it's empty anyway. Might as well do it before, we have resources connected. Okay. Is that blinking fine? Yeah, it's usually fine. We can get some big electric poles. And just decon everything. I will need to wrap these around, which is kind of annoying, but it's not that big of a deal. Don't really know how large I want this to be. But this should. Oh, wait, does this work? I don't know if I can fit a. I think with this, the way I have it currently designed, I don't know if I can fit a beacon in here. I think I need either one more gap or yeah, I think I need one more space. Oh, this doesn't work. There's like multiple reasons this doesn't work. Can I put it here? This would work. Okay. That means I need, yeah, one more tile should work. Right? Let's see. 'Cause we can fit a beacon, which would go right here. Yeah, the beacon would go here, which means we need an underground. We also need to swap where the long inserter is, so we'll just put it on the bottom. That's fine, not a big deal. Beacon. Oh, I have my decon planer out still. Beacon. Okay, that should fit. This left half is going to be the non-beryllium ones, and this right half is going to be the ones with beryllium. And they should be cryoed, or they should have the correct cryo. After I wrap them around, this will just have a double input. Perfect. Yep, that's exactly what I wanted. And then one input, one input. Cool. These are actually the wrong recipe, though, which means they're going to just kind of fall on the floor, but that's okay. What's it called? Just cargo section. Oh, well, that's simple enough. Okay, now they just threw a bunch of stuff on the ground that's gonna stay with me forever, because we don't really use logistic bots, which means anything that goes in our storage system probably is never gonna be a resource that's consumed, which is all right. But who knows how many resources we actually just have lost in storage by this point. Okay. So we could go above or we could go under. I don't know if the side matters. Yeah, I really don't know if the side matters. I could just do. Oh, wait. No, I see a line. I see a line I could use. Wait, do I? No. Yes. Okay. These are gonna swap sides, right? So it's gonna pass through here, and the only reason I'm gonna do that is because I'm gonna use an inserter to pass things over instead. So this will make it that these are prioritized via inserter stuff. Which I don't know if we have enough assembling machines right now for me to be able to justify that, but I don't know, it might be fine. I also don't know how fast these will run. Yeah, who knows? I imagine this won't be super sustainable, but hopefully we get a little bit more resources out of it. We also haven't launched any beryllium yet. And to be honest, our beryllium is not great. Like our beryllium production does not produce nearly enough for this to be a viable rocket part production. How am I missing space belt? Wait, where did I put space belt? Oh, right. There's space belt. Okay, so these will both unload beryllium ingots. That's beryllium plates. There we go, beryllium ingots. Yeah, beryllium produces way slower than I expected. So when I went to set up the beryllium processing plant, it is just so much slower than I could have anticipated. We should have found a beryllium planet and not just done it in the asteroid field. But it's a good enough start. I mean, we do have like 100, we do have an entire space belt worth of beryllium being mined. It's just that's way less than I thought it was. Like, that's three yellow belts of resources. I thought it would make like a decent amount, but it did not. Also, why are these not working? Did I run out of cargo parts? Oh, right, these also need to be replaced with a beacon build. That's fine. Well, actually, do these need a beacon build? Are we low on red chips again? I think we're still low on red chips. Which means decreasing this resource cost won't actually do much. Oh. Let's name it Novice Landing Pad Beryllium. And then for now, we can just, I guess, where do I put the cargo sections that it unloads? Did I really just ask that? Did I really just ask Where I need to put the cargo sections. We are literally unloading this next to the cargo section build. Like, this is the easiest set of cargo sections to unload ever. There we go. That's on the wrong side, though. I don't know how large of a buffer we need. What if we do. Do I have a strong box? I feel like a strong box would be good. We don't have that kind. Do we have this kind? No. Okay, then I will just use a regular chest. And then this will be cargo sections, and everything is still on the wrong side, which isn't great. But I think we can work with that. There we go. We'll just side load it. Okay, so now these should be prioritized over any other cargo sections. We will run into issues if we ever get 100% rocket recoverability, but honestly, I don't think that's a this is a very close goal. And then I guess we can just use some kind of active provider there for rocket components or rocket capsules. These don't need to be stack filter inserters. That's fine though. Rocket capsule. Where's the capsules at? Where are the capsules at? Are they not called rocket capsules? What are they called? Space capsules. Okay, well that makes sense. That seems like an understandable slip up. Okay, let's launch our first one just to make sure everything works. It's a very empty rocket, but yeah, I do need to test it. Okay, so the launch pad that I need would be on Novice. Destination launch pad Beryllium. Okay. We'll just send it. Oh, wait, these aren't working. Oh, I don't send nearly enough sulfur. Oh, okay. Well, that's fine. I did not realize I was requesting such little. I really did not realize sulfur would be in such high demand. Okay, well, that definitely changes things. How can I buffer more sulfur here? Do I have space? Not really here, not really here. Yeah, I figured. Ooh, yeah, sulfur is the highest demand resource. Wow. It's just we had so much sulfuric acid for so long because we were limited by other things. It didn't occur to me that would be the first to run out. I thought I would run out of vulcanite. Do I not have those? Okay, I do not have that. I could. This is very dumb, but this could work. This is really dumb. Do I have fast inserters for this? Oh, this doesn't work at all, does it? Do I wait, why didn't I leave any chests here? Why are there no chests on this planet? I swear I intentionally left 50 chests. I wonder if I left them in my space rocket thingy. Like over, let's see, if we oh wait, you know, there is a way we can skip going up there but up there in person though. We can request stuff sent to here, like a steel chest, let's say 10, and then some fast inserters. And apparently an underground for something. I don't know. Yeah, we'll request 50 undergrounds. Okay, so then we can just send this rocket over to the orbit. Which it seems needs to get an underground first, right? Yeah. Good enough. Except now it has a bunch of logistic box in it, which I don't really want it to have. Oh, okay. I guess it's. How do I fix this? Is there any way to like eject robots from a roboport somehow? Like, is there a decent way to do that? I could use a inserter, right? Like some kind of inserter on a circuit network that offloads them into a different roboport. There's not much space to work with, but yeah, I think that could do the job. But yeah, if we this is really bad, actually. I mean, I guess we're sending it back, so it's probably not terrible, but yeah, this is gonna remove all of the logistic bots that we have on A novice. I guess I could deconstruct it. That's one way to do it. But now it hopefully brings at least some construction pots back. 10? Okay. I mean, that's enough. It's more than zero. Let's just hope they don't get lost in the asteroid belt now. Oh wait, I did not realize that these were powered by my spaceship. Did that have a pylon on it? I think it has like a big pylon on it, because this isn't the first time that's happened. Actually, yeah, no, it does have a pylon on it. Okay, why did this stall? It is missing machine. It is missing blink cards. Why are blink cards low? Actually, why are blink cards low? It sure would be nice if I had a decent design. How did I used to get blank cards? I don't see any way I could have been getting them. Like, oh, I see the problem. When I rotated this earlier, I must have misclicked and rotated this as well. Well, that's unfortunate. Considering how slow we produce science, it would have been nice if things were at least like still buffering, but that's okay. We're not in any rush for anything. Okay, now we have some beryllium, which is being unpacked, and these are not running. I think this belt has to back up before this starts to work, but I think overall this is fine. Then I'll just toss cargo rocket sections in here. I don't know where those came from, actually. Why do I have 20 of those on me? I wonder if I deconstructed something. Cargo pods, rocket fuel tanks, and a bunch of stuff I don't care about. I've never thought that I would say I don't care about LDS, but what am I going to do with that? Like 48 LDS is nothing. I could do a buffer. Is that a bad idea? That's not necessarily a bad idea. Like, we can disable these if these are running fully. Pretty easily, I think, too. So what's a new plan? I don't know if this I no, th there's no way. This definitely outputs fast enough.
Tacos every day. Oh,
Right?
tacos
Will this
every
work?
day.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, it'll work. I think it's completely unnecessary. Yo, what's up, OG Gossy? Welcome. Thanks for the raid. We are making an absolute mess of a base right now. It's rough. It is just getting progressively more spaghetti, and I refuse to make it any other way, which I think maybe was a bad call. But, it's still fun. I'm running out of my resource distribution is really bad, so I'm trying to make more efficient, let's see, more efficient cargo rocket section right now. Yes, an Italian cuisine is joyer for sure. If it's not spaghetti, I don't want it. I will eat nothing else in my diet. Let's see, cargo rocket sections less than zero. Maybe I should set these first. What do I want this to? Oh wait, no, not less than. Oh no, the opposite. Let's buffer greater than 100. Wait, that won't work. This is can only hold 48. The whole purpose of this is just to count stuff, I guess. I don't really need a buffer. Hello, Nero. That's not right. It is supposed to be less. Why did I make it greater than? I thought I was making a pump, some kind of fluid system. There we go. Okay. I think it's still not set up correctly somehow. It's not connected anywhere, is it? It says 48, yet these were still working. Oh wait. It's because the inside one is still working. We just have to. Okay, once we run out of the buffered cargo pods, I think it'll be fine. I could also do this. There we go. Now, Now none of them work. Now it doesn't matter what the internal buffers are, I guess. All of this was useless because I think the only thing I'm short on are these resources. And if I fix red chips, I don't think we have issues at all. So I need to figure out why red chips are broken. Or they're not broken. No, they're working fine. Did I decrease red chip production somehow? Is my math wrong? This is 24, right? Okay, so I went from blue assemblers. Yeah, no, I went from blue assemblers to more blue assemblers. The power could be a problem. Although that it only loses power during most of the night. That's fine. Yeah, I really wish I had nuclear power. Honestly, there's a lot of problems with Novus right now. It is just an absolute mess of everything. I don't think there's a single working part of my base. I really need to switch to, I don't know, probably some kind of train system. A lot of people recommend logistic bots, but I don't quite enjoy logistic bots that much. I find they kind of remove the fun of the game. Like if I do a full logistic base, I would probably just stop the mod. So I'm embracing the spaghetti. Oh, right. And I am waiting for I'm creating a larger buffer system right now for sulfur. That'll work. There are definitely better ways, but not in the space that I had. And then 50, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so we can actually change this to 600. No, not 600, 300. We can hold six times the sulfur now. Okay. How's our cryonite? Wait, why is there cryonite here? What is this used for? Oh. Wait, do I need more cryonite? No, I do not need more cryonite. I don't know why I requested 20,000 cryonite. Did I do this wrong? Hold on. 200 times 45. What's that equal? 9,000. Okay, so this must have been sent whenever I accidentally requested way too much cryonite earlier. I don't think it's a logic problem. Okay, and this should start filling with a lot more sulfur. Oh, that's incredibly slow. Yeah, this is not a good rocket design. I think I need to switch to dedicated rockets. Also, this is still full on cryonite. What did I do wrong? Is that not connected? Wait, is this. Oh, that's the mistake. Oh, okay, never mind. It's not necessarily a logic problem. But it is me connecting the belt problem. Okay, those should work out. Let's just ignore that for now and figure out if we can make red chips anywhere. Our base is a mess. So if we want to make more red chips, we kind of have to make them over here or really, really far away and just make a new base here. So those are two valid options. I don't really know what resources I have available to me, so who knows if either of them are actually an option right now. Coal seems good. This is backing up iron, so I don't consume nearly enough iron, which is definitely a problem. Yeah, because this is cryoed for all of the belt. Yeah, okay, so we consume less than a belt of iron. That's bad. What consumes iron? Maybe I shouldn't have made my steel cheaper. I'm thinking this was a mistake, because this made it that I consume a lot less iron, but apparently I didn't need to consume less iron. What else? Is there any like sink I can make? Ooh, I can make blue belts. If I make blue belts, I'll never have enough iron. That's an option. That would be a decent way to make my base more compact. Although it will take a long time to upgrade it, and it might break things, because it's very likely that I have unintentional belt weaving somewhere. What are my other options? Yeah, I think just switching to a less efficient iron smelting isn't a bad idea. Because if these back up, we lose a lot of our base. I mean, everything will still run, but I really want the core mining to keep producing. They're kind of important. I guess we're not consuming much copper either. So maybe I just need to. Yeah, maybe I just need to make more smelting. And not rely on speed twos that I don't have for this. So I could copy this and build another one. Oh gosh. This base is so bad. It gets worse every second, I think. Like every time I look at it, I realize there's a flaw. Like, why did I make my train right next to my smelting when I clearly had an intention to expand smelting this direction? Also, these are not they're not using they're not making use of how you can pass fluids through the casting machine, which I think makes it less space efficient. Really, there's a whole lot of issues there. I think I can fit this here. I don't know what's on this belt. Vulcanite. Oh, this is an incredibly expensive belt to delete. Like a real oh, this is a really expensive belt to delete. But it will give me the space I need. Like Vulcanite is probably one of my biggest bottlenecks right now. Did that work? I think that worked. Yeah, if I shift this to the left. Oh wait, that won't work. There we go. Like this doesn't run either. What if I put it in a chest? Like I know the resources aren't lost if I delete them. That's not what I mean by it's expensive. But I don't really have I don't really have I don't really have the ability to use logistic bots right now. Or I mean I don't plan to use logistic bots, which means anything that is on a belt and deleted will probably never make it back to the belt. It'll just be lost in storage forever. You can fit it there. That's true. I could fit it there if I redesigned it. I want to give myself a little bit more space. You engineers are so preoccupied with whether or not they could, they didn't stop to think if they should. Oh, no, I stopped to think if I should, and it was a hard yes. I definitely should. No doubt about it. This is a great idea that I will not regret ever in the next, I don't know, 30 minutes. I don't think I need to give it that long before I regret it. But still, great plan. Then we can just go around. Does that work? Yeah, it does. Perfect. Look at that. Fits perfectly. Now I have all the space to work with for better copper processing. Which I don't know if I need. Let's do. This belt is very, very heavily backed up. So I think we can split off of it. Split it again. And we can go here. Oh wait, this doesn't work, does it? How do I do the vulcanite? We have a couple options. There is enough horizontal space that the better option I think will just be to use a long inserter. The other option would be to have belts or pipes go like this, connecting to the other side. Which, if I was limited horizontally, that would definitely be a valid option. But yeah, there's no reason to do it that way with the current design. Hey, input. Wait, does this work? These aren't in the right spot. Yeah, we barely have enough vertical horizontal space, but we do have enough, and that's what matters. And then we can give it prods that it desperately does not need. Definitely does not need. Oh wait, what about beacons? Oh wait, what's the best way to beacon these? Well, I can get five on a single beacon. That's actually pretty good. And maybe I can even like stagger them somehow and make them tessellate. Yeah, that's probably not gonna work well, but what if it does? There's always the chance that it tessellates perfectly and this was a good design. Like, what if this beacon can go here, and then we can get a substation still. Oh, this almost works. The beacon is one tile short, I think. Substation? No, this doesn't. Never mind. It's not even one tile short. It is It's way off. Okay, well that's fine. We can use regular power poles. It is not a big deal. I was just hoping that maybe I could make it a lot cleaner and not have to have power poles on this left side. Okay, then pipes in the middle. And then I think I can... Oh, wow, that tessellates... That tessellates really well. That's like a perfect grid. Okay. Honestly, unexpected. I really did not expect them to actually tessellate. So very happy with how that worked out. No idea why that power pole is there. It doesn't look like it ever powered anything. And then, yeah, we'll power stuff later. This is so many unnecessary power poles. There we go. And now we can copy this and do one more set. Wait, that feels... that. I don't think I have enough copper for this. Or sorry, not enough... I don't think I have enough space for casting machines. If I make it any longer. Yeah, because this is a lot. This is a lot of furnaces, right? Yeah. No, this is a lot of furnaces. But just in case. Sure, why not? Let's double it. I mean, we have all this space to work with. We can put casting machines wherever we want. Wait, is there going to be a belt throughput issue? I can't imagine a situation where this isn't belt or a pipe limited pretty much immediately. Which I think is going to be a very bad mistake. Don't really have a great solution. I'm just kind of hoping it will be okay. It usually isn't. But, like, there is that chance that it is. And I'm really banking on that. Okay, belts. Okay, and now we split out, and then we can put a casting machine. I think... Wait, can we do a double-wide casting machine? I might be able to do a double-wide casting. No, wait, but then I can't output... Ooh, wait, how much space do I have to work with? I have a lot of space to work with. I could do double wide output. Yeah, like you can pass fluid through them, but does that make it easier? I think so. No, it definitely makes it easier. Because then we can output here, here, here. And here. Oh, wait, no, that's way easier. I can even put it a tile over. It doesn't look symmetrical. Oh, wait, it is. Oh, never mind. It's perfectly symmetrical. Cool. This is very nice. Yeah, 100% this is going to have a fluid. There's no way that we can pass fluid through this fast enough, right? It feels bad. Beacon. Oh, wait, do I want a beacon? We can always just delete a beacon and add it later. They're really easy to add in if I change my mind. Substations. Oh yeah, we can definitely do a substation like every 20 or so. Cause this will power a lot. We'll just have to delete like one inserter. Input, wait, no, not input, output. Okay, these should all be powered. Yeah, we can't output at this substation, that's fine. I think, right? Is there any way for me to output at the substation? Oh yeah, very easily. Cool. I don't know what to do about these outer sides. We have a couple options. I think I'll side load that way. We could also side load at the bottom. It doesn't really make a huge difference. Balance wise, it's pretty much going to be the same. Yeah, there is. It really is looking like there is absolutely no way this works like I want it to. I also have no idea what the ratio is, so who knows? Who knows how many wasted machines we'll have here? Wait, what is that? What was in the way there? Okay. This feels like a lot of casting machines that I cannot afford to run. And I don't think I'll be able to test it anytime soon, will I? Depends if we can get speed modules. Let's do speed twos and all of these. I really don't think I can afford speed threes. And speed twos should still cancel it out to have some extra speed. And then we could put speed ones in all of the casting machines and hope that it's fine. Or efficiency modules, considering I am having power problems. I think I need to expand solar again, which means I need a shipment from space. This space. How many? Ooh, wait. That's not that many. I think, yeah, we need to ride the rocket back into novice orbit right now. Oh, look at that. We finally are backed up on rocket components and red chips. By the time we got things set up, we've leveled out our components. Perfect. How did we get this again? Whatever. Don't know how we keep getting cargo sections on us. That will have to be... we'll have to figure out that another time. We can do 40. Yeah, we need some fuel. Yeah, where did those come from? Did I delete belts or something? Did I delete assembling machines? Oh, maybe it was from... Could have been from my personal bots deleting stuff. I'm just very surprised that I keep getting my inventory filled with rocket cargo sections. No jetpack fuel. We're still waiting on jetpack fuel. I keep forgetting to enable that. Cool. Cargo rocket silo. This one's... Oh, this is very full. Yeah, we definitely should ride this. Novice orbit, and then it'll probably start filling up again. Yeah, this is a much better design. So I have basically two types of rockets right now. We have this design, which can handle 35 resources. It's limited more by how many it can unload on the other planet. It could definitely fit more into it, but it can only unload 35. Well, it could unload more, but I would have to do a weird warehouse setup. But easily, it can only do 35. Which is cool, and it means it can fill up the rocket really fast, but you are limited to a couple chests of buffer at any given point. The other design I have uses a filter set to a constant combinator instead. So depending on what is missing, it changes all of these filters. The downside of this, as you can see here, is that if you want it to be resistant to shortages, you need to have regular filter inserters. Because if you have stack inserters, it can only set one filter at a time, and it's going to be what it's missing the most. Which means there's going to be a lot of moments where just nothing runs. So it's either that, or you use regular filter inserters. And if you use regular filter inserters, they're incredibly slow. So I need to fix that. But the whole point of this is that it's easy to set up and change the values. This one's way harder to change the values on, or way more tedious to change the values on. But it definitely works faster, so haven't decided which one I prefer. Logistic bots in a requester chest are obviously the fastest, but what's the fun in that when you can have almighty spaghetti leading to one rocket, and then when I have to build more than one of these, everything will be a complete mess, and it will be fantastic, and I'm looking forward to that. Okay, should be in space now. Cool, I'm going to be honest, I was not confident that I actually got on the rocket. Very, very happy it worked out. I didn't bring any beryllium with me. Which means Astroscience is beryllium limited. Why didn't I bring beryllium? Ah, there we go, beryllium ingots. And I feel like I only need 500, sure, kind of a random amount. I didn't think this through. How do I get beryllium down there? Beryllium ingot. And then I know the multiple layers of filter inserters here are definitely, they're unnecessary, but they give me peace of mind. Because it means if you make a mistake, you have to, if you make a mistake and put things in the wrong chest, it doesn't go out onto the belt. So while the filter here is completely unnecessary, it is nice to have some kind of protection for when I inevitably mess up. Could I piggyback on stone? No, I cannot piggyback on stone. All the way on the other side of the base. Oh, but there's a one tile gap on the outside that is completely perfect. Wait, did I plan for this? There is a small chance that I planned for this all along. I don't think I did. But I might... Yeah, no, never mind, I didn't. I was hoping to give myself the benefit of the doubt, because it looked like maybe I did plan for it. But as soon as I get to the bottom, I realized that is not true. I did not plan for it, I just got lucky. And then I guess that is a way to pass... Wait, will that work? No, because I need to unpack it first, which means we also need a assembly machine. Space assembly machine. Which can go here? Yeah, that'll work. Then I'll just copy this one, so that way I don't need to try to find the belt. Delete, delete, delete. Really don't need any. We don't process beryllium here anymore. So this stuff is just kind of a relic of a past design, which we got rid of pretty quickly when I realized that shipping beryllium ore is terrible. Like 100 times worse than shipping ingots. I figured I could take like a 20 times, like a 5 or 10 times hit. No, that 100, 200 times hit though is a lot worse. I could not stomach that. Okay, let's see if these work. Oh, right. This is why this design is annoying. Because if I change how much I request, I have to change it in like 5 different spots. So I definitely need to change how I think I need to change my request. This is also not working. Enable beryllium less than 500. That's it to beryllium. This is requesting beryllium. Is this one not requesting beryllium? No, this one's requesting beryllium. Wait, what did I do wrong? Oh, nothing. Was I just blind? Was that working the whole time? Or did I run out of power? No, I could have run out of power. I have the... Part of the reason that design is so complicated is it's brownout proof. If we start running into power on the space station on the top, we don't run into issues where we are sending things that I am not supposed to send. So we have the request, like, cancel out each other, which I think is a weird way to do it, but it does work. Basically, we request up here, we say we need 500, but then I also say we already have 500 on novice, so that way if we're not getting this request as well, it doesn't send anything. I don't remember why I did it that way. I think there is something else that I think there is another part of this that I wanted, but I do not quite remember it. There was a reason. I wonder if it had to do with automating. But yeah, I don't think the double combinators were necessary. And it was like 20 hours ago at this point, like multiple weeks ago. So I really, really do not know what I was thinking. We should be able to send another rocket soon. There's something I was waiting for it to build to see if it worked. Oh, this. They are... Throughput limited? Pyroflux limited. Pyroflux limited. Wait, what? Oh. Okay. Not because I ran out of Pyroflux. That would have been bad. We are limited on Pyroflux because I just didn't connect Pyroflux. And then I'm also limited on speed mod. So it's really hard to tell if this is getting enough. Where can I send these? I think... Oh, we can delete some trees. That would be helpful. Trees and rocks only, just delete everything. I thought I already did this. I don't know why I'm still deleting trees at this point. This point in the run. Okay, and then we can send stuff up and around. There we go. I like this. I think. Do I like this? Yeah, that's all right. It's a bit finicky. I could have just outputted them up and around instead. I kind of, as I was building this, I didn't realize it went so far down to the south, though. So I wasn't even thinking about that. Okay, so that should help our copper shortage. Or, I mean, we don't really have a copper shortage, do we? That'll help our copper smelting. So that way I can get more red chips. And we also have more green chips here, which I can't tell what they're limited by. I don't think they're limited by anything. I think I could actually split off of this and make red chips right here, which is a terrible spot for it, which means I have to do it. I don't tend to go for the good spots. So yeah, we can just make wires. Don't know if I need more meteor defenses on this planet. I also need to check the Informatron to see where the next, what's it called? Energy beams? This thing? Tomagus Orbit. I have no idea what Tomagus Orbit is, so I'm assuming that is not important. Also, wow. That one's 6 gigawatt. A 6 gigawatt beam. That sounds really high. But yeah, it doesn't matter because I have no idea where Termagus is. These are working. Yeah, I mean, we're just not launching enough rockets. I think rockets are cheap, so I can start automating them now. Because we're up to, let's see, we're up to base is 20, so we're up to 52% rocket part recovery, which is actually a lot. And I also potentially halved the cost of rockets from these things, or nearly halved the cost of rockets, aside from the light oil, but I mean that's not that significant. So yeah, I imagine we're good to start automating rockets. Maybe I should just say like send if half full, but also have another condition. Yeah, I think we tried to automate them. That's what this is for. But I didn't know what I wanted I didn't know exactly what I wanted to automate it with. I could do an and. Can I do an and condition? Oh, that's an option. If anything less than 51, I have no idea why where 51 comes from. Or maybe each? No, anything. Yeah, okay. That could work. So we can say auto launch if anything is less than 50 and the rocket is half full. That seems very valid. So I don't want to actually output a green signal. I want to output something else. What can this output? It outputs, is it F or E? I don't think it matters. I could do E greater than F. That's an option. So we can just connect this up to this combinator, or no, we'll connect it to the next one. F, wait. Empty, wait. Which one's E? They both look the same. I have to pull up the Informatron for this because I cannot actually read the bottom of the letter. I'm assuming E is for empty, but I honestly don't trust that. E is empty slots. Okay. So yeah, this will be if it's half full. Wait, does that work? Yeah, E greater than empty or full. Output. I guess we can output anything, right? Like signal with an input of one and then also zero with an input of one. Sure, I don't think it really matters. Then we connect both of these to the outputs. And now, if this is true, it will output green. Because this only lets you do cargo. Yeah, this only does green and cargo full. But honestly, I want to launch if cargo is like even half full. So, what is this outputting right now? Let's actually disconnect it because I don't know if I set up the first one right. Empty slots less than full. Empty slots less than full. Why is that working? Oh, wait, I see the problem. There we go. I was like, that should be true. It does need to connect to the logic, though. Okay, and then now we can say if 0 equals 2, which it should, output a green signal. There we go. And now, auto launch when green signal or cargo full. That didn't work. Why did that work? It did work. Hey, that's our first automated launch. And it kind of felt somewhat manual, but yeah. That's an automated launch, I'll take it. Actually, do I want to connect this somewhere else? Nope, it's not functional though. I did not set it up correctly. Did I? I can't tell. I feel like I did not set it up correctly. Which one is the one that's outputting? True. I don't know. For some reason, right after launch, it said it was still equal to 1. Maybe there's a delay. I mean, it seemed to work out just fine. Yeah, we'll wait. I think it'll be okay. There is a problem where if our balance isn't correct, this won't really work. Which could be a problem. Like, if we ever completely run out of only one resource in novice orbit, it won't be automated anymore. But that's why I just said half full. I figured half full would be good enough to make it that doesn't happen that frequently. Because that would require us to just very much prioritize one specific resource. And then this is working. Okay, we have astroscience again. That's good. Wait, am I actually beryllium limited for astroscience? Well, that is something I was not expecting. Is it output? I feel like it's output limited, right? Yeah, it's definitely output limited. Because we have a single... Yeah, I have a single long inserter here. There we go. Sure. I want to... I think I could have just done a belt. But I also wanted a little bit of a buffer. Okay, wow. This is so... So bizarre. We actually produce astroscience for once. I mean, the reason, if you didn't see yesterday's stream, the reason why it's so exciting is because this was our astroscience yesterday. Which one is it? This one. This was our astroscience yesterday. Mostly flat with occasional spikes. So like it didn't even average like one. It didn't even average, like, half per minute. But now we're up to, like, 3 per minute. Well, except for right now when we're bursting out a ton. But yeah, we're averaging, like, 3 per minute now, which is so much better. It's, like, 6 times as many, I think. Because we are limited by telescopes entirely. And now we're limited by power, which is a problem. But yeah, we put speed mods in all of these, so that gave it an 80% boost. And then we also tripled how many we had. So that's roughly 5 to 6 times more. So very, very happy about that. We finally have like a decent amount of production of something, which is something we've never had before. We always underproduce things, which is, I think, the opposite of what a lot of people do in bases, in large bases. But yeah, I constantly do the bare minimum, which is usually not great. Okay, that is a problem. This might help fix the problem. I don't know if it necessarily fixes it. I think, yeah, I need more gates. Doing bare minimum sounds kind of boring. Well, I mean, it's not like I intentionally do the bare minimum. It just ends up that I completely underestimate how much I make. Like, the other day we did copper smelting, right? Like, I set this up, and it looked like the amount of machines it had, and since it was so much, like, of a step up from like a regular smelting lane. It just felt like it was going to be an excessive amount of copper, and it turns out that this was not enough. This wasn't even like half of a red belt of copper until I got speed modules in it. So yeah, it's not like we're trying to do the bare minimum. It's just, I'm very, very underestimating how slowly things produce in space exploration. Oh yeah, no, the base is a very spaghetti mess, which is fun, but it's also really hard to expand things, which I think overall is worth it, but it does make it really, really hard to tell where resources go and where I need more resources. Like, hopefully this will give us a pretty significant increase to our red chip production. I still need to figure out how to get plastic over here. I also just need more plastic. So I don't even know if I can get more plastic. Oh, I have petroleum issues. Okay, oil is running out again. That's not great. Is it a crude problem? If it's a crude problem. Yeah, it is. Okay, I do have a solution though. We have speed twos now, I believe. So we can go back to Novice Orbit in the correct menu. Or not Novice Orbit, Novice Planet. I don't know why we're still in orbit. It would be a lot easier to fix stuff if I was actually on this planet. We'll just upgrade everything to speed twos, which will give us a pretty decent chunk of oil. These don't have any speed. Wait, where do these connect? What do these go to? Wait, are these not connected to my grid? Because that seems like a very easy increase to my oil production. I have no idea where these go. Something tells me that these don't actually connect to my grid. These just power flamethrowers. And I think that is correct. Can I get a train on here? I don't think so. Wait, where's the. Oof. Technically, I could get this oil without having to set up a new train. I want to just go straight up, though. Is that an option? I think so, but it requires a lot more roboforts than I would like. Yeah, I'm sure they'll get built eventually. They're gonna have throughput problems very quickly. Yeah, we'll just go down, see how it works. Do do do. Okay, where is the oil? Okay, is this oil that is this already connected? I feel like something's definitely not right. But it's really hard to follow this oil line, especially when I keep pressing N instead of M and exiting the satellite view. Okay, so there's clearly some pipes. Where were they? Like, where do these lead? These lead around. Oh, I remember now. The reason that this goes up and then down is because I was just doing it in map view and I just guessed where it ended and I was off by like 50 tiles. So I just went around and down. And now it's coming back to haunt me because it's just because it looked like maybe a pipe I could use, but it turns out it's just a mess. Sure. I imagine that will be okay. There we go. Now we're limited by other things again. Wait. Wait, do these not have an input? No, they do. Okay. Okay, we're back to being limited by telescopes. That's the important thing. That means we have succeeded in my goal. Those are working. Let's grab a capsule. Is there any way to automate capsule filling? I don't know if there is. It would be nice, but I don't think it's necessary. Okay, is there anything I should leave up here? Not really. Yeah, we'll just. Wait. Where's my ship? Did I ever recover it? No, I did not. Okay, we should probably send this back. Let's see. It lost its bots. Yeah, that's expected. I'll actually keep this here until I can confirm that sulfur is being sent to beryllium. It looks like we sent a lot of sulfur, but I need to make sure the chest distribution is good. Okay, we have beryllium. Well, we haven't produced beryllium for a while because I kind of forgot that the base was dead. What are my options for oil? Like, I am running low on crude, but I also just don't have the I don't have the refineries. So we need some beacons, I think. Gosh, this is not a design that was meant to use beacons. Yeah, that's an option too. I kind of forgot about liquefaction. Yeah, we could do that if we really can't find enough crude, because I think we do have plenty of coal. Another option, let's see. Let's try using this. I haven't used this mod before. I downloaded it, but I haven't actually used it. Let's see if it does what I want. Export to blueprint string. Import. Is it that? Is there any way to directly just use this? Okay, I see now why the someone recommended the I see now why Deacon recommended the simplified version. But I can directly make it a blueprint. Yeah, I don't know how to use this one at all. Import string. Why is it a blueprint book? And why doesn't it have anything in it? What did I do wrong? Is that what I did wrong? Okay. There we go. Got it work somehow. Yeah, let's try liquefaction after this inevitably does not do what I want it to. Okay, now I can just. This is a weird design to copy, but I think it'll work. Really, probably should have made sure I set it up correctly before I started deleting things. I can't fit it here. I can't fit it there. Well, I can fit it here. It's just gonna be awkward. I can put it in the hotbar on the right of the UI to make space for it. You can put it in the hotbar on the right of the UI. I don't know what that means. Remove the blueprint button. You remove the blueprint book button for it. But if you don't have the blueprint book button, how can you get a blueprint from it? Ooh. Oh, is it this thing? Cannot dock more items. Let's see. We can remove something here. Wait, that's not the right one. No. Maybe? Is this the right one? Can I, like, click this on a beacon? So this is like, this upgrades things, I think. Okay. I hope that wasn't important. Okay, so I can use it kind of like the other inserter mod on stuff that are already placed. I see. It's starting to make sense now. Why can't this place? Pipe is in the way. Pipe is in the way. What? Oh. Wait, what? Why was that copied like that? Is that a problem? I don't think that's a problem. Yeah, I have no idea why that pipe at the bottom was copied. Okay, well, that's fine. Not a big deal. Now we have significantly more oil production, as in, like, I think we almost doubled it. Maybe not quite. Yeah, not quite doubled. 60%? Yeah, that's still good. I need to figure out the oil problems because we'll have those soon enough. I could set up liquefaction. I really want to figure out why these don't do anything. Maybe bots are... It could be that bots are still building. Because this is a bit far away. No, that seems... Well, okay, it might not necessarily be hooked up. Because this is two sides of an oil pot, oil pipe. It doesn't seem to be missing anything, though. It could be a pressure issue. Wait, no, this isn't... Wait, where does it go? What is this pipe? It goes so many different directions. It's so hard to follow. This is a weird design. It goes over to the right, then it goes up. And that connects to the... Wait, so where does this connect to? Do these not intersect? They didn't look like they intersected. Unless it goes around again. They don't seem like they connect. What if I do this? That might work. I have no idea why there are so many pipes. I have a square or a rectangle of underground pipes over there. I don't understand why. I think a lot of it was I just placed pipes in the wrong spot and I left them, which was a terrible idea. Oh, and then these could use an upgrade. And then this is actually getting a lot of crude. But not enough. We might need a pump here. Or like a secondary row of tanks. Could be good. Because, I mean, these mostly fill while this train is on the way. This actually has a lot of production. Which means if I upgrade these, we can get even more. So maybe we don't... I don't think we'll have an oil issue for long. We could also use beacons and get even more oil. And then just... We will have to hope that we don't start running into other problems instead. Because there is a good chance we'll run into power issues if we expand our base anymore. Like, we're already struggling with power. Okay, but at least we're back on Novice. Don't remember how to exit a vehicle. There we go. Decon. I don't want this. Thank you. Okay, well, these are backed up. I'm just going to keep making red chips and like we actually need them. And just pretend. What if I... Okay, I could put... Ooh, wait. Do I have a great option here for more plastic? These are already beacon, but I could upgrade them. I feel like these are going to be coal limited. I can maybe fit something in here. Yeah, I think that would work. Then we'll just output wherever we want, and we'll sideload them here. So that way we can split off half of this plastic and send it elsewhere. Yeah, okay, that works. I don't think that the coal is going to suffice, though. So we need to figure out how we can speed it up. Because I imagine we had a red belt at some point, and then we drop it to a yellow belt. Although, we don't have that much more of a belt. Oh, but yeah, we can definitely get more. We can definitely get more out of this. I have no idea where this coal comes from, but let's assume that we need more of it. Oh yeah, we have more than enough coal. Okay, we just need to make sure this is a red belt at least past... At least past the plastic, the old plastic lane. Cool. This base just gets worse. One day, I swear, I'll switch to trains and, or even like a bus. Honestly, there's lots of options that aren't this one. But we also all know that's a lie. I don't think that'll actually happen. But what if it does? Like, what if it does happen? It would be a great base. There's hope. I mean, we still have like 10,000 other sciences that we have to get right. Like, there's plenty of time for me to give in and change my mind and actually use tanks or trains. Missed a splitter for the upgrade. Wait, are splitters not in the upgrade planner? No, they're not. How did I miss a splitter? They just click on both sides of it or something? Let's see. Splitter is good. Oh, yeah, I must have just like stopped. I guess that makes sense. It was around a corner. Thank you. Although the main thing is that we had yellow belt at least past here, or red belt at least past here, but it definitely is good to have it upgraded all the way through. Okay, so those will be powered. Now we should be getting more plastic. We'll move a beacon down. There we go. Okay, so the whole idea here was to be able to split off of this plastic. So how do we do this? I think we flip it around and then maybe split off of it. Where is a splitter? We'll actually pryo it towards the other side. Anything extra we can send back towards LDS, that probably isn't a bad thing. We can't get a pryo for a bit. But this is pretty close. Yeah, this is really close. Okay, so we should have plenty of red chips soon. And I mean we really I don't need red chips right now, but I'll need them really soon. So that's why I'm still building this, even though I clearly have already waited out my red chip bottleneck. But you know, once I start launching rockets again, I think the or once I actually get my rockets automated, I think we'll start to have issues. So I really might as well prepare for it. I mean, that's kind of the goal of today. Okay, so we have this belt. How do I want to do red chips? Red chips and green chips. Okay, they use the same amount of plastic as they do green chips. So we'll just side load them. And then I think I'll just go under over here. Yeah, there we go. That's good. And then we can use a beacon design if I really want to. Actually, that's a good idea. Beacons are very useful and cheap, especially compared to yellow. I think beacons are cheaper than yellow assemblers, aren't they? Or at least not necessarily cheaper, but they're definitely worth using. Input, long inserter, long inserter, long inserter, long inserter. That is not correct. We can't really power things great that way. There we go. Now things are nice and powered. Okay, and we have to wait for the beacon, right? Or I could use one of the beacon designs I already have. Yeah, sure. I'll just use that one. Okay, and then send it down. Feel like I want at least. What do I want? I want at least prod twos in these. They're also not called red chips. What are they actually called? Advanced circuits? Okay, there we go. And then for these ones, I'll just use the regular inserter because I don't actually have something set up for this. Okay, so I think this was actually a bad design. Unsurprisingly. I will instead go around. Because I don't want to have to like completely loop. Nah, never mind. Nah, I think the original design was all right. And it wasn't great. But if we have to use a, if we have to waste a few belts to loop it around, that's not a big deal. Switch to worse power poles. What are they called? Long power poles? Power pylons? Big electric poles. There we go. Long power poles. I don't know why I couldn't remember those. I mean, we haven't used them much, and we pretty much never use them. Never really used them until this, so I mean, it makes sense that I don't remember the name. Okay, this is 100% not the right ratio. But what if we upgrade these to like speed threes? Then it might be the right ratio. Oh, these are not set up correctly. I am not using this mod right. Think that's what I'm coming to realize. Okay. What if we give it speed threes, speed threes, speed threes. Did I ever finish efficiency threes? I know I wanted to. See, we have efficiency twos here. That makes me think no. Yeah, no, we definitely did not finish them. Okay, that'll work. Hold to create blueprint. Is that right? Yes, it is. They were both green, so I couldn't really tell if it was functional. Okay, more red chips. I don't know where to send these. I really, really do not remember where these needed to go. But it is more red chips. Should be almost double the red chips. See, where's the lowest priority? Or actually, no, where's the earliest I can connect them that actually helps? Oh, no. Can I get them over there? Is there any world where I can actually get red chips over there? Yeah, there is. Okay. This is going to be the greatest spaghetti of all time. Okay. I didn't kind of check to see if I was lined up correctly. I just assumed that we could cut through here. And it looks like I was right. Okay, I don't think anything's broken. And look at that. Wait, am I relying on side loading anywhere? Oh wait, that's not the right one. Like, does the side matter? Wait, this isn't where most of my red chips go. Okay, never mind. This is a lot more complicated than I thought. This is where most of my red chips go, though. So, I mean, it's not inherent. Like, it's not bad if I just load them up here. These do get sideloaded, so I need to make sure we add an artificial sideload, because I will be combining to both halves of it now. I mean, that should work. I think what we can do to make up for this... Oh, we can't do a prio. Because then we don't get blue chips. Also, I think I can increase the buffer size of blue chips would help. Well, it'll help me tell where my bottlenecks are. See, destination full, we're running out of crude. Perfect, that's exactly what I wanted. I definitely don't need oil. Oh, wait, these are working. Kind of. Okay, I think it's a pressure issue now, which makes sense. It is a very, very long pipeline. And then they connect to these tanks. Oh wait, this is bad design. I realized a problem with this. How do I fix this? I guess it's only bad for this first batch. Once this empties once, I think it'll be okay. Because what this will amount to is it's just gonna request trains when it's like 30% of the way full instead, or 70% of the way full. I don't know why I have efficiency twos being requested. I also don't know why I don't have any gates. I guess I do let myself use construction bots for stuff like this. So let's just make a gate assembly machine. Or sorry, logistic bots for things like this. Okay, and then we'll give it a substation instead. Substation. Or actually, no, we'll just power them from the outside. Wait. That's not right. Yeah, there we go. Okay, that won't work, will it? I don't think I put stone walls anywhere. Or engines. Wait, gates need engines? Oh wait, single cylinder engines. Those are basically like slightly better gears. Okay, that makes more sense. I kind of forgot that gates were made out of just regular stone walls. It's been a while since we've had to build them. I wonder if there's a mod that makes that different. Because that also explains why they're so incredibly weak and keep breaking. Okay, so copper seems good. Honestly, copper is really good. Oh, are these not getting enough copper now? Ooh, that's cool. That's exciting. I never thought that being low on a resource would be a good thing. But it means we actually are like consuming stuff for once, which is very exciting. It means we actually have kind of a base. Okay, there we go. That will connect up to two belts of copper to this. Hopefully we start consuming iron as well. Pyroflex. As long as I did it right, this should be designed to only work if Pyroflex runs low. Yeah. Yeah, we don't use a ton of this. Cool. We get most of our Pyroflex from just the core mining, because it actually produces a lot. I mean, you can power a lot of industrial furnaces with just core mining. I figured we would need to be importing a lot more. Okay, these are still missing beacons. So I can't tell if we can expand it anymore. I mean, I could do math. Or I could just expand it and pretend I did math. That's another option. Yeah, let's do that one. That's a solution I'm fond of. Delete these, and then we'll wrap it around here instead. There we go, 30% increase, possibly, or not at all. We'll see. It's more, though. It looks like more, even if it isn't actually more. Hey, beryllium is good. Is it actually producing again? Yes. And it has, like, 8,000. Okay, this is very nice. Oh, wait. Oh, this isn't. Oh, this is good. I have no idea how much I filled the rocket. We might explode, which is not great. This is not producing that much beryllium. Sorry, I guess it wouldn't explode. I think it just deletes it. I don't think it chest explodes if you send a full rocket. It just gets deleted. But yeah, I accidentally requested 10,000 more sulfur than I meant to. Which I think is bad. I mean, I can't imagine it's good. I guess I can downgrade that back. Yeah, that should be fine. It unloads slowly, but I think it unloads fast enough. Everything's connected. And beryllium, okay. Yeah, we're fine. Beryllium is now, I think it's mining limited? No, it's speed limited. I wanted to make a trip back there with speed twos at some point. But that will happen. That'll have to happen another day. We can go to novice orbit. Hopefully, I really need to start double checking before I click the shiny button. Like, one day we're gonna cause some massive problems when I just click launch and realize we're at like 2,000% stress. Or we didn't select the launch pad. Not sure what to do about this. I need to automate beryllium at some point. But the thing is, I just don't know how much beryllium I really use. Not until we get rockets up and running again. How's this? Oh, wait. I think the automation is working. Let's go back to novice orbit. Is everything running? We don't have any empty belts. I think I actually... Oh, wait. We ran out of petroleum. Okay, well, that's an easy fix. That is an easy fix, because I can just do this. Right. And now... Now I can buffer a lot of petroleum. So we can do this. Let's see, we added like 6 chests, right? So let's say 2,000. So now I can buffer 300 barrels of petroleum up here. I don't like how I have to change this in 3 different locations. Really not a good idea. I wish I remembered why I set it up that way. Like, there was a reason, it was so long ago. See, how's my solar panel production? Oh, wait, these don't connect. Oh my gosh. These don't connect to... Uh-oh. These do not connect to space. No wonder why my solar panel production is so bad. Where is our other solar panel production at? Where can we piggyback off of this? Oh, that's really close. Oh, that's really easy. It is, but I think I don't know why I had to put it on both sides though. Because I think the same thing could have been accomplished. I think the same thing could have been accomplished entirely remotely. But I just couldn't figure it out and I gave up. But yeah, it had something to do with power. It definitely had something to do with power outages. I just don't remember why I couldn't get it to work the other way. Okay, so that should help a lot with solar power. I don't think I'm producing enough substrates. That's an easy fix. Because we seem to be backed up on resources. Also, scrap might be a problem. Let's just expand this. There we go, and then we can forget about it for a lot longer. These are not powered. I also cl very clearly did not need the expansion, but that's okay. And I actually want to prioritize these ones. Yeah. Okay. The base is looking a lot. Well, okay. Visually, the base looks a lot worse than it did earlier. But our protection is a lot better, which is the important thing. And I have an automated rocket. We're making more than enough cargo sections. Rocket reusability is almost up to 50, like 6% or something. 52%. Which is very nice. And then this should be saying, yep, okay, this should launch soon. This should launch soon. Because it only launches when it's up to like 200, 250%. Honestly, I think I should just start landfilling things because we need to build more soon. This landfilling this will definitely cause some issues with how full the rocket is. Or not cause issues, but if I landfill it, I'm definitely going to need the rocket is going to be filled to the brim with steel, plastic. Wait, plastic? Steel shielding and LDS. So yeah, time to start expanding this. There we go. What? That doesn't. I don't need it there. There we go. Okay, so I should be able to build a lot more in space next time. And then maybe I should expand up here as well. Maybe not that far. But I mean, it's better too much than too little. Which is something I've not been fol a mantra I've not been following lately because everything is just so hard to expand. Beryllium is fine. Okay. Yeah, that looks decent. And then this is gotta be filled to the brim with petroleum barrels, which is awesome. Is it? Wait, why is this only moving one at a time? Okay. That explains a lot. Oh, right. There was a moment in time where I thought the issue with this rocket was stack sizes. But then it turned out that I just didn't connect the rocket. Yeah, it was weird. It definitely was not the issue. But it took me a while to took me a while to realize that I just hadn't connected the wire. But in my defense, look how these wires are connected. Like I cannot tell what connected to where. So yeah, we just straight up did not connect any of this storage to the transmitter. Like not a single chest was connected. They were on their own separate grid. Okay, I like this rocket. I could probably automate this one if full, right? I don't know where it needs to go. We don't really have an output. It needs to go here somehow. And it needs to be unpacked. And prioritized. Yeah, that requires us to set up splitters, which I guess isn't that hard. I could set up the recycle for this pretty easily. The only issue is going to be dealing with the space capsules because we don't have those designed well. Okay. What else? Is there anything else I needed to do? I don't know where these batteries are going. I think we have a chest somewhere that is completely uncapped. Oh, no, it's just we're backing up on like a 1,000 tile long belt. Okay, that would do it. Somewhere along the line, we're saying, hey, we need to buffer 2,000 of these batteries, which is, yeah, gonna take a while. Not necessarily an issue. Red chips seem good. No, red chips are more than good. Does that mean RCUs are producing healthy and these are producing healthily? Ooh, okay. Yeah, I don't know what my goal will be next time. I think Iridium? I think I want an Iridium planet. Because I would like to make cheaper heat shielding. What does Iridium take? Let's just look at the chain for a bit. Wait, do I not have Iridium yet? Wait, can I make Iridium? Iridium? I don't know what that is. I'll have to look back at that. Okay, we do have Iridium processing. What is this? Iridium delivery cannon capsule. Oh, you just have to research the ability to put it in a capsule? Wait, what is this? Is this a different recipe for making delivery capsules, or is it a capsule for delivering Iridium? Let's see. Increased durability means less... Oh, okay. So it's like the same thing as like the heat shielding recipe or the cargo recipe. So it's just a cheaper way to make these things. Oh wow, that's way cheaper. Okay. I thought it just meant I had to research the ability to ship Iridium elsewhere, which is not a great interpretation. It doesn't make any sense. I had no reason to think that. Okay, so we need sulfur, stone tablets, iridium plates. Okay. Iridium plates. Wait. How do I make iridium plates? Definitely not like this. Oh, this is like some kind of... This is some kind of science thing. You get the iridium back. Okay. Okay, so it's like... Looks like it's very similar to beryllium, where I have to make the ingots. There's only one recipe for this, so it does require pyroflux. It requires blast cakes, which requires vulcanite. So if we could find an iridium vulcanite planet, that would be useful. I don't know if those exist, but it would be really helpful. Then we have iridium powder, which comes from cation exchange beads, plastic, vulcanite, sulfur. Or from cryonite and beryllium. This seems cheaper. Because I have no idea how to get any of this stuff. I think this is a later one. Iridium needs enriched vulcanite is the trickiest part. Enriched seems pretty easy to get. I mean, you need a supply of sulfur, but we have enriched vulcanite. Actually, on our other planet, we have too much. On our vulcanite planet, we have too much enriched. Oh, wait. We did at some point. Now it's sulfur limited. Okay, maybe it is a tricky part. Why isn't this getting enough sulfur? Oh. I don't know. I don't know why. But I can't imagine it's good. Yeah, there's clearly problems here in this supply chain. It wasn't a problem. But if we can find a planet with iridium, we could ship vulcanite to it. Wait. If I ship vulcanite, is there any way to ship vulcanite that... Can I revert it back to a enriched somehow? Probably not. Okay, you're right. It is a little bit tricky, because that means I have to ship both vulcanite and enriched vulcanite, which I do not have both of those. Let's see, I should probably dock this before I forget. Anchor to novice orbit, it just goes anywhere here. Okay, so what are our options? I think I scouted out an iridium planet that I liked. Universe Explorer, sort by priority. This Iridium? And this one had 0% biters and it didn't have biter meteors. I think this is the place to go. For sure. Because, yeah, this is the other option. So, yep, looks like we'll be going to Hera. It's the wrong button. View surface. Okay. So this has... It has iridite. It has water. Stone, iron. Oh, crude. Wait, so I can locally produce all the sulfur we need. That'll make it a lot easier to enrich stuff. The only problem is that means I need to ship pretty much everything that I mine. Yeah, this is the first like multiple. I think this will be the first multi-planet logistics chain I have to set up with rockets. And ideally automate. Cause like I'll need a rocket that goes to my Vulcanite planet. Cause I'll need to request enriched. I'll need acid to mine it. Ah, okay, well that's not gonna be a problem then. That actually just makes it, like, we'll already have it for the sulfur. So yeah, basically we need, on our Vulcanite planet, we'll need to send a rocket there with all the components to launch another rocket off that planet, or we can do local production. But I think our best bet is to ship rocket parts. And I guess if we're shipping rocket parts to that planet, that will also mean we can switch our delivery capsule to a delivery rocket, which probably is better anyway. And then we'll have a rocket going from the Vulcanite planet to this one. That ideally brings refined Vulcanite, Vulcanite blocks, and enriched Vulcanite. It could also, if I really wanted to, I could... I don't know where I would want to enrich. We have a couple options there. I could either enrich it on this planet or on the other planet. I don't think it really makes a big difference. I'm assuming transferring the enriched is probably better, though. Yeah. Transferring the enriched is more dense by like 30%. But yeah, no, that won't be a problem. So actually, we won't need sulfuric acid. We won't really need sulfur here because we'll just enrich and then send it directly over. Unless there's another step of the recipe that I'm forgetting. That just needs a rich. Like these ones. Oh, wait, coal. Oh, I don't have coal on this planet. Is reverse coal liquefaction a thing? Is there a reverse to this process that I could use? I don't think so. But yeah, I don't have a way to get coal on this planet. I mean, technically I do, but it looks like I have 8,000 coal total, so I'll need to ship coal. Or ship plastic, but either way, it's shipping something else. Yeah, it does not have much coal, but this is still a decent planet. Okay, I like this all right. That'll be a good goal next time. This isn't terribly complicated, but if it's anything like beryllium, I'm gonna get there and then realize I am incredibly limited by mining speed. Yep, it is incredibly limited by mining speed. Wait, can you only use big mining drills? Oh, cool. I mean, it doesn't really make a big difference, but that's cool. I didn't realize they would be required for some things. That's going to be a fun adventure. I do not think we'll successfully do it next time. Also, why do I want this to launch automatically at half full? I feel like automatic launches should be mostly full. So maybe I should do full is greater than... like 350 or 400. Let's only do auto launches if it's like 80% full. That should be fine. I need it in. Honestly, I should have had a larger chest system. Or maybe just had separate rockets. There's a lot of things I could have done differently here. You get a refund on cargo rocket parts up to half if it's partially empty. I thought that was just on... I thought that was just for liquid fuel. The refund is not worth it. I mean, we also, the reusability, you always get that, right? Hello, Pack Plays. Welcome, welcome. Rip. Is there rip? Now we're good. There's just always blinking. We lose a lot of bites to fire. Also, are these guys stuck? Oh, testing random emotes. Fair. It just happened to line up with the fact that we also lost like 20 bots. And maybe some walls. Are they stuck? Well, okay, they're definitely stuck, but are they important? Probably not. I think we could help if we put a power pole over to the side. Oh, that was way too many power poles. Okay, well, that will help a little bit. Realistically, I should just landfill this, but yeah, whatever. Not important. Okay, so where does it mention the refund? It's just such like a wall of text. Can't wait for the update to bot pathing. Oh my gosh, that update is gonna be so great. Like, pretty much everything that I've really wanted to do this run will be fixed in the update in like a year from now. Because that one, I ran into a lot of issues with bot pathing earlier when I first started making my walls. It took an incredibly long time to fix. First paragraph under the bullet points. Ah, there we go. Thank you. If a rocket is launched with empty cargo slots, then some of the reserved fuel and cargo sections will not be used. Or an empty rocket will still cost 50%. Okay. So you get a refund of up to half. Oh, is that what... Okay. Rereading this sentence... It does say... Okay. The way I read your original sentence when you said you get a refund on parts up to half, I read that as up to half an empty rocket, which is a really weird way. There's no reason I should have read it that way. But I read it as if the rocket has less than 50%, you get a refund of less than that. I don't know why. It's not even a sentence I can try to explain because it was such a weird interpretation that I read gave. But yeah, the bot pathing update will be incredibly useful, and there was the yesterday's Friday Factorio facts. That's not the right order. Factorio Friday facts. The one about the super forced, ultra forced construction. Probably too many adjectives, but the idea is that it will automatically place landfill, which is so useful when you realize bots are getting stuck over a lake, because then you can just paste a bunch. You don't have to do it in like 10,000 different steps of placing landfill, placing one roboport, and then checking back later. I don't know which one I'm more excited for, actually. They both sound fantastic. This is going up. You've not heard of... Yeah, they just announced it yesterday. Super force building. There we go. Okay, I added a few too many adjectives. It's not super forced, ultra, super, but it still seems exciting. But yeah, basically the gist of it is it will automatically place landfill, and it will make it that if you place a building, like, on top of a belt or something, it will delete the belts, and if it can, go around it, it will also replace them with underbuilds. So, like, placing a beacon, if you realize you didn't place a beacon, like, in the middle of a build, will be really easy. Or if you don't want to delete, like, some random power pole, you can just force place over it. It just sounds so nice. The trains update? Oh, it's adding the two-tiered trains. I completely forgot about that. Yeah, that one seems good, too. I'm very happy to see that the Redship line that was our only goal for today is completely backed up and useless. Very happy about that. You're also looking forward to the Super Mega Power Force building. Ultra Hyper Attack. Yes, it's going to be great. The build on water mod is kind of clumsy. I forgot that was an actual mod. I've never tried it. Okay, I need to track down the efficiency modules. Is it these? Are you requesting an efficiency 3 somehow? How could I have requested an efficiency 3? I don't know where this came from. Wait, which upgrade planner was that? There we go. Every Factorio Friday Facts just adds mods into the base. Honestly, yeah. Like a lot of updates for Factorio are just like, oh, this used to be a mod, but now you can do it in the base game. Which, I mean, I'm not complaining, because they're great updates. It's super happy to see them, like, including these ideas in the base game. Okay, that got most of them. I'm still missing a single efficiency 3. Where could it possibly be? It's blinking here. It's not working though. I wonder if it's just it could just be a bot cycle thing. Cause like this is the only blinking on the planet. Okay, yeah, I think it was a bot cycle thing. Okay, cool. Let's see. Oil is decreasing. How easy would it be to just not do oil in such a dumb way? Is that a fix I can do right now? I think it is. Because these are backed up, right? Yeah, okay. Okay, we're going to make a train. Which might be a bit harder than I thought. It depends if we have a Roboport. I think I have Roboports all the way over here. Yeah, we can do a train. The two-tier trains is going to end up so... It's going to end so much more spaghetti? Or is it going to make the spaghetti worse? Because when I saw that, I'm just like, oh my gosh, people are going to have so much more spaghetti. Like... You can use it to avoid spaghetti, but I feel like it will be used to make even worse spaghetti. Or at least that's my thought. Oh, it's going to end up making so much more. Okay, so we have the same thought. Got it. Yeah, that's my thought as well. You want to see what the Renite Transportation guy does with rail bridges? I like to think that if your train is powered with nuclear fuel during Renite Transportation... It will just naturally become a ramp and launch off of it. Like, not intentionally, but they'll just make it that if you have a ramp, it gets launched and you have no choice in the matter. Okay, I think this will be fine. And then with the way that I have the logic of this set up... Oh wait, this will not be fine. I can go around. The way that I have the logic for this set up, I believe this will work. Oh wait, this doesn't have a tank. Yeah, that's fine. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I have one single oil stop, and it always has the same name. We got rails, as long as we didn't miss any rails. Okay, this should fix our oil problem. Oh wait, we missed some rails. How did I miss so many? Wait, how did I miss so many rails? I'm very confused. Oh, I didn't know you could even it would even let you place it like that. Okay. That makes a lot of sense. I was not holding, I was not doing the super plus ultra mega Power Rangers force building, which I guess we don't have yet. But yeah, that was the issue. I wasn't holding, I guess this one's just regular, the regular force building. Wasn't holding the button when I went through. Okay, let's place this down, get some walls. Although this is just a secondary gate, so if this one isn't covered, it's actually not a problem. Okay, so hopefully we set that up right. I really don't like these. But if I delete them, I think it wastes a lot of oil. Eh. Might as well delete it now. Because otherwise they're going to be there forever. Yeah, it's not a huge deal. I wasn't happy with how those were set up, and if I don't delete them now, I'll just regret them later when they cause problems with other logic. Because I think they made my train stop logic not work very great. And it just made it that I ended up with a lot of wasted oil anyway. Okay, they should be powered. That actually built a lot faster than I thought it would. I guess it's because we do have like 5 or 6 tiers of bot speed upgrades by this point that they actually, you know, work. Okay, and then I can't really test a specific spot, but I should be able to click here. Okay, yep. Okay, we should be getting a lot more oil then because this is a big oil field. Well, it's an okay oil field. Do we have any more oil I can get? Not really. Yeah, hopefully this fixes our oil bottleneck. We might have to set up coal liquefaction sometime. Or someone did suggest finding an oil planet. Or they did an oil planet in their run. That's something we could consider. Like this planet right here could work. It has an insane amount of petroleum on it, right? Oh, press the wrong button. Universe Explorer, Mantis. Wait, what is. Wait, what's a crude oil mining fragment? What? What does that make? 160 crude, okay. I mean, it makes sense that it makes oil. It seems weird to mine for oil that way. Okay, this actually doesn't have as much oil as I was thinking. Maybe it's not a good idea. Might need a better oil planet to consider it. Okay, where am I? And is this set up correctly? Okay, we'll launch if less than 400, greater than 400. I might have set the number too high. Nah, never mind. It's okay. And then, did we actually fix this planet? Yes, we did. It's up to 1,000. It's up to 1,000 beryllium. This is so slow. The only way I could really expand it, though, is with speed twos. Yeah, maybe I'll do that next time. Lots of goals. Find iridium. Add speed twos to beryllium. Seems like good goals. Oh, wait. I also need to fix power. Nah, that's fine. My base dies during the night. It's not the end of the world. That's a good stopping point. So yeah, I should be back tomorrow. Hopefully we can get iridium next time. Because I think I fixed most of Novice's bottlenecks, or at least delayed them for a while, which means I should be able to focus on space again. But thank you all for watching. Thanks for the raid. When Ribbon World, I'll be continuing that on Monday. Since that's been my Meme Run Monday run. So I should be doing it Monday, and I think I can finish it Monday. Because I believe the only thing I'm missing now is yellow science. But I'm also playing with a controller, so we'll see. if not, it will at least be finished Tuesday. But yeah, don't worry. That one, have not forgotten about that. That's just for the meme runs, because it's chaotic with a controller. But yeah, have a wonderful evening. Peace.